Weeds cause different problems in Christmas tree plantations. In young plantings, weeds compete with seedlings for light, water, and nutrients. In older stands, woody species or vining weeds such as bindweed or Virginia creeper can affect the growth and shape of a tree, reducing its value. There are several ways we can classify weeds: by botanical family, their growth habit, or their life cycle. Most herbicide labels make a distinction between annuals and perennials, and between grasses, broadleaf, or woody species. There are a number of weeds that can become a problem in Christmas tree fields if left unchecked. They include bindweed, bittersweet, dewberry, crabgrass, and horseweed, to name a few. Field bindweed, Convolvulus arvinus, was introduced to North America from Eurasia. It is a long-lived perennial with an extensive root system, reaching depths of 20 to 30 feet and repeatedly giving rise to numerous long rhizomes. Field bindweed is a member of the Morning Glory family and shares the family's vine characteristics. Bittersweet. Both the Native American bittersweet and the introduced Oriental bittersweet are deciduous woody vines. Their flowers are inconspicuous, but they are easily recognized by their yellow fruits with red seeds that appear in the fall. Of the two species, Oriental bittersweet is more aggressive. The vines can form dense thickets and wind around trees and shrubs, often girdling them and killing them off. Dewberries comprise a number of species in the Rosacea family. They are closely related to raspberries and blackberries and produce similar aggregate fruits, though they're usually unpalatable. The vines usually have small spines or thorns, making hand removal more of a challenge. Crabgrass is a very aggressive annual grass. It grows in clumps, becomes very thick and patchy, and tends to choke out the more desirable plants surrounding it. It starts growing in early spring from seed, and if left unmowed, can reach heights of 2 feet. Horseweed is another weed we find in Christmas tree plantations. It is a winter or summer annual. It has hairy and linear to lance-shaped leaves. The stems arise from a basal rosette, and it can grow to a height of 6 to 7 feet if left alone. It easily can crowd out young seedlings, so it is advisable to keep this one in check. Control or the management of weeds often rely on the use of chemicals. However, chemicals have pros and cons associated with their use. Some of the pros include the fact that some of the chemicals can be very convenient. They are less labor intensive, and often there is less of an investment in equipment needed to apply them. Cons include things like some of the chemicals can be very expensive, they require an applicator's license to apply them, multiple products may be needed to manage all the weed concerns you have, weeds may be resistant to the chemical control products, and finally, the performance of some of these chemicals are dependent on weather. Therefore, before jumping right to the chemical control option, we recommend you consider an IPM approach. An IPM, or an integrated pest management approach, would include identifying weed pressures, understanding their life cycles, and determining the acceptable levels. You would then review available management practices, evaluating the results. You may need to modify your plan based on the results you receive. The use of herbicides is an effective method for managing weeds on Christmas tree plantations. Pre-emergent herbicides prevent annual weeds from germinating, while post-emergent herbicides manage weeds that are already growing and established. Success with herbicides depends on using the right product at the right time. You need to read product labels carefully to determine how effective it will be against your weed pressures, and at what point in the growing season it should be applied. Make sure that your application equipment is calibrated and adjusted to deliver the proper dose of herbicide, precisely where it needs to go. Improper use of herbicides is unsafe, often ineffective, and may even damage trees. There are also non-chemical practices that growers can use. Regular mowing discourages the growth of broadleaf and woody plants, since many of these species don't tolerate repeated cutting very well. Cultural practices such as cleaning off field equipment between fields or planting densely can reduce the chances that weeds get introduced in the planting, or that they'll be able to germinate and grow. Keeping the ground covered with low-growing grasses and clovers limit the amount of bare soil available for weed seeds to germinate and become established.
This concludes the weed section of this course. So keep in mind an effective weed management program incorporates diverse strategies and practices to keep weed populations off balance. Multiple strategies are essential to prevent weed shifts and herbicide resistance from developing. These strategies include proper identification of important weed species, prevention of new introductions, and use of biological, mechanical, and chemical controls.